Welcome to END student for discussion on instruments. First we take the head mirror. Head mirror was first tried by Avery in 1840. It is a concave mirror. Concave mirror means it is a converging mirror. As you could see here, this is the concave mirror. Its central aperture 2 cm diameter. Mirror itself is 9 cm diameter and it is worn on the forehead like this, and there is an aperture to see all the structures, so we can keep it on right or left eye based on our provision. It helps us to have our both hands free. Actually, this light from a 100 watt bulb which is coming from that, which is a point source, it is converged by means of this converging lens, that is convex lens present in the bull's eye lamp, which is placed behind the left ear of the patient. This is the patient, behind the left ear of the patient. This light comes and falls on this concave mirror, which is a converging mirror. It converges at a distance of focal length, which is 18 centimeters. You can remember, like 9 into 2 is 18 centimeters. This is the focal length. So 9 centimeters is the outside diameter. Aperture diameter is 2 centimeters. 9 into 2 becomes 18 centimeters. Just for remembrance, this has to be focused, which is the from light coming from the bull's eye lamp from behind the left ear of the patient. The distance between the doctor and the patient should be nearly 30 centimeters. The doctor and the lamp, bull's eye lamp, should be nearly 30 centimeters. That implies towards the patient's left ear also. So the distance from here to here is nearly 30 centimeters. Once after the light comes from here, which is a point source diverging light, it has to be converged with this convex mirror, that is convex lens, that is a converging lens. Opposite of a converging lens is concave mirror, which falls on it and it converges the light upon the patient like this as a focus. Once you want to see the ear, you have to focus the light on the tragus and then retract the spina posteriorly, laterally, so that you can see whole of the external auditory canal along with the help of a ear speculum. So this is how a setup of a head mirror lies. And if you take the head mirror, so this is the head mirror which we are trying to explain. This is the particular concave mirror that is present over here, and then this is the aperture. This is 2 centimeters, this is 9 centimeters. And the distance, the head will be here, the distance has to be in between the mirror and the bull's eye lamp has to be nearly 30 centimeters. This distance will be 30 centimeters and the focal length of this is 9 into 2, remember like that, it is nearly 18 centimeters. So when we take the, how it works, so you can take, this is as a mirror. And this is how the light is being focused. That is the focal length, the distance. Almost you could say one point is forming, means that the focal length distance. And the distance between this and the bull's eye lamp should be nearly 30 centimeters. So this is the convex lens that is present in the bull's eye lamp. And this is the concave mirror that is focusing onto the patient's tragus. This should be on the left of the patient. If here is the patient, this should be the left of the patient. And doctor should be sitting in the chair with both the limbs towards, and then it should be towards the left side, and the patient comes this side and then comes and sits here, and the doctor will be examining him. Thank you for watching, END student.